The six suspects linked to the death of activist Caro Mwatha, namely Michael Onchiri, Betty Akinyi, Richard Ramonya, Alexander Gitao, George Achieng and Stephen Maina will spend 2 weeks in custody. The six who appeared before Makadara Chief Magistrate Heston Nyaga were detained after the prosecution successfully argued they were safe in custody owing to the immense public interest in the case. The court ruled they be remanded within the Buruburu division for their safety until 27th of February when the case will be mentioned. The body of activist Caro Mwatha was found at City Mortuary a week after she was reported missing in what police say could have been a botched abortion.
The suspect has been tortured.
Meanwhile, Judy Wangui Mungai, businessman Michael Gedai Madenge, and Wambui's husband Joseph Kori, linked to the murder of Mary Wambui, will spend an additional 9 days behind bars. Kiambu Senior Principal Magistrate Stella Atambo ruled the prosecution arguments to detain them to allow the transfer of their case to the DCI Homicide Division had merit. The defense, in seeking to have them released, argued the suspect Judy was being tortured while in custody, prompting the judge to allow her to be transferred to Modaiga Police Station from Juja Police Station. Her husband and his alleged mistress Judy are being treated as the key suspects in her murder.
The upshot of all the above observations is that the prosecution is granted an extension of a further nine working days to complete investigations.
On this application are the following.
Finally, the High Court has upheld the decision of the Magistrate Court, which ordered the sampling and retesting of fertilizer currently at a go-down in Mombasa. Justice Daniel Ogemba directed that sampling be done tomorrow and retesting to take place on 15th February 2019 in the presence of officials from the Kenya Bureau of Standards. Among the nine accused persons is former KEBS Managing Director Charles Ongwae. For Scales of Justice, I'm Ben Troy Njue.